Good afternoon to everyone. My name is P. Sangeeta. I am from BSc MPC first year. My topic is time and tide, wait for no one, from value orientation. What is the meaning of idiom, time and tide, wait for no one? The meaning is that time moves. In other words, it never stops for anybody. Time and tide, wait for no one, this idiom is apt in today's world. As the world is moving at a fast pace, nobody has got time to waste. Moreover, time never stops. The clock is ticking. Therefore, to use our time, we should work hard every second. Because if time once has gone, we cannot regain it. It is the most precious thing a person can have. With time, everything is possible. It is just that you should have a dedication towards utilizing it. Also, various successful people know how to manage their time. And that is the reason they are successful. You can earn money by using time, but you can never earn time by using money. Since we all know the story of the rabbit and tortoise, right?
Yes.
I have one question. The rabbit was not able to win the race because... Why was the rabbit not able to win the race? Any have answers?
Can anyone
the
answer?
Rabbit was not able... Okay, the rabbit was not able to win the race because he wasted his time in sleeping. So this story is perfect for this idiom. If you know the story, you must be sure that time and tide wait for no one because the tortoise world worked hard and utilized the time so he was able to succeed in the race. Also, our life is like that only. To achieve success, we must work hard with time. Moreover, we should always utilize our time in the best manner. Only then we will be able to achieve the success in life. Your time is limited, so don't waste it living someone else's life. No matter what, time will be proceeded. Thank you.
Well done. Sangeeta, well done. Anita ma'am, Suchitra ma'am.
Very nice, ma. Sangeeta, very well done. And again, like Vaishnavi, you have also supported your, saying, or the proverb with a story. So that makes it more effective because these are universal stories and everybody can relate to it. So just being theoretical may not put the point across, but when you give an example, like you did, very good. And your language is good, fluent, very nice. Keep reading loud, keep practicing, keep reading, so you will improve your language skills. Very good, Sangeeta.
Thank you, ma'am.
Suchitra, ma'am.
Yeah, very nice, Sangeeta. I was impressed by your presentation. And what I liked the best quality of yours was that you started off with a question. Yeah, it is like you're involving the audience. In between also, you have put a question. So I think this is one of the techniques that we all should have while presenting a paper, right? That is, you not only just coming and telling what you know, but also involving the audience. So I like that point very well. I think others can learn from this. But excellent. As Anita ma'am said, your language, your expression, the way you have presented it, everything is very good. And please keep improving yourself. You can do much more. I mean, you did it better. I won't say you have done it very excellently. There is a lot of potential. Keep improving. Thank you.
Okay, ma'am. Thank you.
Sangeeta, well done. So what I've got to tell you is care when you are using the microphone. The cloth was disturbing the microphone, maybe on the phone or maybe the fan was loud. So whatever that light disturbance during pronunciation, because the mic was touching your chunni or dress or maybe the fan was at a high speed, that disturbance is there. So microphone management is something that you have to take care. Otherwise, pronunciation, okay. Pause, the way you have handled, involved the audience, it's all very well done. Keep it up. Good.